Hello everybody, my name is Fulbert Baudouin. We've seen the basic tagging conventions and for control loop, and now we can move on to the presentation of the CHEP symbols and lines for equipment connections. Let's take a look at this figure again. We saw in the previous parts that a level transmitter LT, L for level and T for transmitter, measures the level in the tank and transmits the signal associated with the level reading to a controller LIC with a display to indicate some data, I for indicator and C for controller. The controller compares this measurement with the desired value at which the controller variable should be maintained, the desired value or set point, and adjusts the manipulated variable which has a direct effect on the controller variable. The manipulated variable is, in this case, the flow rate with the control valve LV at the output of the tank. LV for valve in order to adjust the flow for level control. In these P and ID diagrams, alarms are used to alert operators to serious and potentially hazardous deviations in process conditions. Some questions remain unanswered, like why LT and LV are surrounded by a circle, or why the controller is a square with a circle inside it. Where are these devices localized and what kind of controller is being used here? How are the pieces of equipment connected together? Which kind of signal transit inside? This third part aims to answer these questions. We are going to explain the various symbols and tagging conventions to indicate the function of this device, to show where the various devices are localized and how they are connected to one another. The what and where aspect can be determined from the symbol shape. The why part comes from text placed inside the symbol that is made up of two parts. This forms the tag number. See part 2 for further explanations. The symbol shapes are largely based on the accepted ISA 5.1 standard. This table shows the various symbols used to define the device and to locate it. Relative location is indicated via the presence of centered horizontal line or lack thereof, a dual centered horizontal line or a dashed centered horizontal line placed inside this symbol. The where part of a symbol is provided by the four columns of the various shapes: circle, square, square with circle, etc. Let's refer to the row D in this table. A circle symbol is quite simply an individual physical instrument or device in the field or on a panel. It doesn't matter if it is a level transmitter, a flow meter, a pressure gauge, or some other type of indicator. If it is a physical device that measures or displays something, it will be illustrated by the use of the circle on a P and ID. Notice also how the tag number LT101 is placed inside this symbol. The common practice is to place the device function abbreviation on the top line with the loop number at the bottom. The next row in this table shows a hexagon. It means the computer is used for the process control. Have a look at row B on the table. A diamond within a square is used to define function within the programmable logic controller, a PLC. A programmable logic controller is an industrial computer control system that continuously monitors the state of input devices and makes decisions based on a custom program to control the state of output devices. This slide describes the main component of a PLC in more detail. A central processing unit, CPU, serves as the brain of the PLC. It is a 16 or 32-bit microprocessor consisting of a memory chip and integrated circuits for control logic, monitoring, and communicating. The CPU directs the PLC to execute control instructions, communicate with other devices, carry out logic and arithmetic operations, and perform internal diagnostic. the CPU runs memory routines, constantly checking the PLC to avoid programming error and ensure the memory is undamaged. Memory provides permanent storage to the operating system for data used by the CPU. The system read-only memory, ROM, stores data permanently for the operating system random access memory, RAM. It stores status information for input and output devices along with values for timer, counters, and internal devices. PLC require a programming device, either a computer or console, to upload data onto the CPU. PLC reads signals from different sensors and input devices. These input devices can be keyboards, switches, or sensors. Input can either be in digital or analog form. Robots and visual systems are intelligent devices that can send signals to PLC input models. Output devices such as motors or solenoid valves complete the automated system. Now let's look at row A on the table, the ones that show a circle inside the square. This kind of symbol represents devices or functions that are part of a shared display and shared control system, a distributed control system, DCS. A DCS combine one or more PLC with a human-machine interface. A distributed control system is a specially designed control system used to control complex, large, and geographically distributed applications in industrial processes for the chemical process industry. With this, controllers are distributed throughout the entire plant area. Controllers are distributed geographically in various sections of the control area. They are connected to operating and engineering stations which are used for data monitoring, data logging, alarming and controlling purposes via another high-speed communication bus. For instance, these symbols are used to represent a graphic on a computer screen or control panel that you can see and possibly interface via touchpad or mouse. It might be used to show the level in tank or represent a hand switch that you can click on with the mouse to start a pump. The point is, if you can see it on the control screen, it will be represented as a circle inside a square on a PNID. Now, we are going to focus on the various lines of this table. There are 5 lines. Concerning the first line, line number 1, all shapes symbols have no horizontal or dashed line inside. That means devices are located somewhere in the field, probably close to the general area shown on the PNID. Concerning the second line, all shapes symbols have a single horizontal line. That means devices are located on the main control panel near the control room or some computer screen in the main control room. The lines used have to be lighter than the associated process piping. Concerning the third line, all shaped symbols have a single dashed horizontal line. When you see such a symbol, that simply means that you can't normally see it or work with that device in the field. It might be installed behind or inside a panel so that it's normally not in view, inaccessible to the operator. For instance, a circle with a dashed line in the middle means it is an instrument or device that you can't normally see or get to. If you are an operator, it is probably something you do not need to get to, but it might still be vitally important to the plant control system. That is why we show it this way on a PNID. In a similar fashion, a graphic display symbol with a dashed line in the middle simply means that this portion of the control system is password protected. Alternatively, it could mean that it is hidden from normal view on a screen or operating panel, so you can't get to it, unless you know the secret access code. On the fourth and fifth line on this table, all shapes symbols have a double horizontal line or a double dashed horizontal line. On the whole, these kinds of symbols are infrequently used. A double line means the same thing as a single line, but devices are in this case located on the secondary control panel and not on the main control panel. The same goes for a double dashed line. You will notice with this kind of symbols, no specific location information is provided, only that the device or graphic is associated with a relative general location. In many cases, it is not hard to figure out where something is, just from where the symbol is on the drawing. But there are limits to what this symbol can convey. Now, we are going to explain the different line symbols that connect devices and equipment. The key line types are highlighted in the figure. By far, the most common line type is a solid line, which is used to represent a pipe. Other common line types that you should be able to identify are first electrical signals, second instrument air to control valves or devices, and third, software or data link, which includes virtual communication, such as what occurs inside a computer program or PLC ladder logic. The software can include anything that happened inside the computer, but you need a functional description to actually know what that is. Just note that when you see a software lines, it means computers are at work, leaking the devices in some meaningful way that relates to the system controls. In this part, we have explained the different shape convention for the AESA 5.1 standard in order to specify the location and the role of each device. You are now able to explain and understand every control loop shown in the P and ID diagrams. For each control loop, you know how to define the controller use and its locations, the various sensors put on the chemical processes, the various alarms in place, the different kinds of transient signals. The example shown at the beginning of this part can be analyzed again in detail. The shapes surrounding the controller, LIC, a circle inside a square, shows that this controller is part of the shared displays, like a distributed control system, or just a control panel that you can see. The single horizontal line inside the shape indicates that it's probably located on the main control panel near the control room normally accessible to the operator. LT and LV are surrounded by a circle. As explained previously, the circle symbol is quite simply any physical instrument or device in the field or on a panel. In this case, it means a sensor transmitter for the level, LT, and a control valve at the output of the tank, LV. Concerning the different connections between devices, the solid line indicates that the sensor and valve are connected directly in the process. The dashed line between the controller LIC and the valve indicates that the controller transmits an electrical signal to the valve. Perhaps, in this case, the valve is an electric valve. The electrical signal is, in general, a 4 to 20 mA current loop. In the same way, an electrical signal is used to link the transmitter with the controller. So, we are halfway through this unit, and the next part will cover final control system symbol and the different kinds of valves. Mm-hmm.